Welcome to my channel. Today I am going to do long term analysis of Tata Motors. I am sure many of you would have bought this particular company because of the strong brand image at around 450 rupees or maybe 500 rupees. But this company is falling from past two years continuously, and in just last 1 year this company has fallen more than 30%. I am sure many of you are stuck in this particular company and unable to make a decision whether you should continue to hold this particular company, or you should buy and average it, or you should completely come out of this particular stock. In this video, we will try to find out why this company has fallen so much in the past 2 years in the first place. Secondly, we will try to find out what actions the company is taking in order to revive the business and what are the future plans of this particular company. I am Ketan Agarwal, your investment coach. Let's start with the analysis. So let's start with long-term analysis of Tata Motors. This video can be a bit longer because I have to cover lots of information in this particular video. Before starting, I would like to add 3 points here. This video I have made in English language. The same video I have made in Hindi language. Link for which I have given below in the description. Yeah, video mein English mein bana raha hun. Iska same video maine Hindi mein bhi banaya hai. Jiska link maine niche description mein diya hai. Secondly, this is a long-term analysis. This is not a short-term analysis. So do not take any short-term trade based on this analysis. Thirdly, please subscribe to our channel so that you can continue to watch such type of videos in the coming future. So starting with table of content. In this presentation, I am going to cover introduction of the Tata Motors and auto industry in India in general. New product development. What are the new product the company is developing? Reason for poor performance of in the past. Why the company has not performed like good in the past? And what are the strong action plan the company is taking in order to revive the business? What are the future products of the company? We are going to talk about the finances of the company and the Stockaholic report card, where I am going to give my personal review, personal opinion of this particular company. So starting with auto industry in general, if you see in the auto car industry, there are lots of changes are happening in this particular space in last 1 to 2 years. Like the companies are developing connected cars, and for like connected car, it's like it is connected to internet, and where like lots of like any diagnostic or something can be done online itself, and lots of you can track lots of information about your car through the app or something. And safety, for the safety feature, the company is developing new things, like ABS is going to be compulsory on all the cars. Like from the government side, it is a new law is coming. Every car has to have ABS and airbags, and all those measures are coming. So on the safety side, the companies are doing a lot more compared to the past. Eco efficiency is increasing. Like a company recently, all vehicles started coming with the BS4. Now by 2020, they have to make BS6 engines, and the government itself is pushing lot of this electronic vehicles and hybrid cars. The company is also making lots of investment in this particular space into hybrid car and electric car, because these are the futures of the company. So, and autonomous car, like without a driverless car. So this many technologies have been the company are working in this particular space in this to develop this technology in the recent past. So these are the changes happening in the industry. If you talk about Indian auto industry is one of the largest in the world, and it contributes 7.1% to India's GDP. And four wheeler only has 20% market share in India. What that means is, out of 100 vehicles in the row, 80 are two wheelers, and there are only 24 wheelers. Out of that 14% are the passenger vehicles, and the rest are commercial vehicles. So the market share of car in India itself is very low right now. So there is a big opportunity for these car companies to increase their sales in the coming near future, because if you see, per capita income of Indians are increasing year by year now. So because of that, the demand for car is going to be increased a lot more in the coming future. India export also grew like 15.81% in the last year. That is a very good for Indian economy itself. And various initiatives are been taken by government in order to push electric vehicles in India. Like Karnataka government is planning to set up charging station across Bangalore. And in 11, the government of India has identified 11 cities where electric vehicle will be used as a public transport. And government in India is targeting 6 million electric vehicles and hybrid cars by 2020. That is a very good initiative by the Indian government. And government is planning to procure 10,000 electric vehicles for their use and out of which like Tata has been awarded two contract for 250 cars as of now, which the Tata company has already delivered electric car. So introduction to Tata Motors. The market cap of Tata Motors is around 98,000 crores, and it is the India's largest and a global leading manufacturer of car, utility vehicle, buses, trucks, and defense vehicles. So the company has presence in they make compact cars and sedan, and they have utility vehicles, buses. They have trucks, and they have a defense vehicle as well. The company has 76 subsidiaries in India and abroad, and Ionic brands like Jaguar, Land Rover, and Tata Daewoo, which is a South Korean company, comes and it is a part of the Tata Motors now. And Tata Motors is known for its quality, originality, engineering, and design excellence. If you see in the recent past, like in the last 2 to 3 years, the company's design language is completely changed. It is now the car looks much more beautiful compared to what it was few years back. So if you see, Tata Motors has they have acquired this company Jaguar Land Rover, and they have partnership joint venture with Tata Daewoo, which is the second largest player in South Korea in medium and heavy truck market. And Jaguar Land Rover is Britain's biggest car manufacturer. Now we are going to cover insights of Tata Motors. They have presence in both commercial and passengers and commercial vehicles. They have 6 plants in India: Jamshedpur, Pune, Lucknow, Pantnagar, Sanand in Gujarat, and Dharwad. So they have complete range of in commercial vehicles. They have complete range starting from 1 ton to 49 ton, and in passenger vehicle from 5 seaters to 81 seaters. And they in the passenger vehicles, they have presence in like compact size car, mid size car, sedan, SUV, utility vehicle, hatchback, and crossover cars. They have presence in all the areas. So these are the product portfolio of this Tata Motors. If you see, this is into mainly commercial vehicles, starting like Ace Jeep is there, Super Ace, Magic, Xenon, and different types of truck, defense vehicle. You can see these are the type product portfolio of Tata Motors. And these are the passenger vehicles like Sumo, Nano, Indica, Bolt, Tiago is the new one, Hexa is a very good one, Indico, Jazz, Tigor, and they have Tata Nixon as well, and they are the presence in the defense vehicle as well. You can see in the pictures here. Now talking about Jaguar Land Rover. Jaguar Land Rover is Britain's largest automotive manufacturer, which they have their own design, manufacturing, and sells some of the world best car, premium cars in the world. So there are two brands basically, Jaguar, which deals in high end luxury cars, sedan car, sports car, and luxury performance car, and there is a Land Rover, which is they have specialty into SUV segment. So they have presence, global manufacturing. They have in China, they have Brazil, they have manufacturing unit. Slovakia, they have manufacturing plant in there. They have presence in Austria also. So these are the product portfolio of Jaguar Land Rover. If you see, they have been to premium segment, sports segment, lifestyle. These are the product portfolio of Jaguar, and this is the product portfolio of Land Rover, which are their presence in like a premium segment, leisure, and dual purpose vehicles. Now we are going to cover Tata Motors embracing the future of mobility. Like Tata has created a new sub brand which is called Stamo. In that, they've launched one car called Racemo, which is a like future ready car, and it is a like connected car and very personalized. It can give you a very personalized different type of driving experience altogether, and it can be like you can personalize that car to according to your need. So that is the like first step towards a change in the towards the future ready car. This is the first step taken by the Tata Motors. And in Jaguar Land Rover, they have something called InMotion, which is a technology, digital technology, that is a which offer digital solutions. Like you can online diagnostic of your car can be done, or you can review the performance of your car, how the company's car mileage, you can check the tire pressure, fuel, everything can be done through online through the app. So that is the InMotion, which is used in Jaguar Land Rover car. And Jaguar Land Rover is working towards connected autonomous car right now, and they have advanced driver assistance system like automatic emergency braking system, parking assistance system. They have also sort of technologies. Cloud car again, this is an online platform, and they're also planning to go full electric by 2020. So new product development, what is happening in under a commercial vehicle, 10 products are being the company is planning to launch 10 products in the medium, heavy and intermediate commercial vehicles. In passenger, they have already launched Nixon. Because of that, the company's markets addressable market share has increased from 60% to 75%, because the company was not present in compact SUV segment right till now. Now with Nixon, they have entered a compact SUV segment, so the markets addressable market share has grown up because of this. JLR has launched so many new car. They're planning to launch like Velar, XF Sports Brake, and major facelift is going to happen on the Range Rover Sport, Jaguar E-Pace, and Jaguar I-Pace, which is a completely electric car. It runs on batteries. So next we are going to cover what is the reason for poor performance of this particular company in the last 2 years. Why this company has performed so bad, why the company's share has fallen so much in the last 2 years. In this slide, we are going to cover that only. The basic reason is because of the fall in the market share of passenger vehicles and commercial vehicles. That is the most basic reason of this particular company. The share, the market share of this particular company has fallen in the both the segments, passenger vehicle as well as commercial vehicles. The reason for this is lack of adequate responsiveness to the competitive environment. The company did not respond well to the competitive environment. If you see other companies like Hyundai, they develop so many cars in the passenger segment, like i10, i20. They came with so many new models. The Maruti Suzuki itself, they revived the whole company. They came up with the luxury brand of Nexa, and there are so many cars under Nexa right now, like Baleno, Ignis, and all cars are good. So Honda also revived so many. They came up with so many new cars, but Tata was stuck with Indica, and after that they came up with Nano. Lots of problem happened with Nano, and the company suffered huge losses because of Nano, and so many time got wasted. And after that, the demand for that car was not much. Because of that, the Tata Motors was suffering, and because of this, the company delayed in launching new products in the market. So if you see commercial vehicle segment, the market share of this particular company fell from 59% to 44%. Because other companies, because of this, Tata was not able to develop, so other companies' market share increased, they sold more, and this company, Tata Motors, started to suffer. Passenger segment declined to 5.2% from 13%, 8% fall, more than 100% fall happened in this passenger segment. Performance was also got affected because of the BS4, what government initiative took in order to cut the pollution. So BS4 happened, and then sluggishness in responding to the market and on time. The company did not respond on time to the demand of the new products, and delayed in launching in new products in the market. So what strong action plan the company is taking in order to revive the business? The company is now giving the renewed focus and reducing the cost base of this particular of the entire operations, and they're streamlining the supply chain, ensuring timely delivery of new product. If you see in the recent 1 year or 2 years, the company has they've developed so many new cars now. If you to name a few, Tiago, Tigor, Hexa, Nixon, and this has never happened in the past. But in the last 2 years, the company has launched four cars Now they're coming up with electric cars, and they're planning to come up with electric cars, automatic cars and all. So lots of development is happening. On June 20, 2016, the company started a new initiative of future ready, to manufacture future ready car. So the company has four angles to attack. First one is top line focus. The company is planning to increase their revenue by selling more car. Cost optimization, customer centricity. The company is going to focus on the needs of the customer, and the structural improvement, internal improvement in the company will going to happen. The company is also strengthening the other business as well, as Tata Finance and spare part business. And the company is focusing in sharing technologies. If you see, in the same platform, they're making different vehicle, Like in the car segment itself, Indica and Ace uses the same engines, so there's a technology sharing happening between the two cars, and they are also sharing the platform, like pickup trucks and utility vehicles uses the same platform, and they are also increasing the market share in other countries like Kenya, Nigeria, Tanzania, Saudi Arabia, United Arab Emirates, and Qatar. They're expanding their market in the eastern part of the world. Middle East, they're expanding the business to the Middle East as also now. And they are also the dominant player in Bangladesh, Nepal, and Sri Lanka. They are focusing more on Australia and Asian countries, and they've already entered countries like Indonesia, Malaysia, and Philippines. And the primary operation of JLR, Jaguar Land Rover, in the UK, it is also and now they are also expanding the business to other countries like Brazil, China, and India. And the response from India and China is really, really good. We'll see in the future slide the company is getting very good response from these two countries. So now we are going to talk about future ready products of Tata Motors. In under commercial vehicle, the company is planning to go completely green fuel, which will be run through electric car, or maybe it may use solar energy. And on the passenger vehicle, they're trying to reduce the complexity. They're trying to use the same platform in order to manufacture 2-3 cars, like Tigor and Tiago uses the same platform. And smart buses, these buses will be run on LNG, liquefied natural gas, or hybrid, or it can be electric bus. Jaguar Land Rover I-Pace they are planning to launch this car, which is a full battery operated car. Now Tata Motors commitment to zero emission, they are developing fully electric car, and starting from small commercial vehicles to 12 meter long buses. Fuel control, they're planning to develop efficient engines, so the pollution can be less. Hybrid buses they are planning. And engine downsizing, they are planning to make a smaller engine and more efficient engine in order so that the pollution will be less. And motorized EGR system, when the gases come out through the exhaust, it will be more refined, the carbon content will be much more less. So that is a new technology and better fuel economy. So Tata Motors has already delivered a first batch of electric vehicles to EELS. If you see this, the company has developed electric Tigor, which is the company has already delivered to the government 250 cars, and the range of this car is around under single charge it goes to 130 kilometers. So it can be a very good city car. Okay. And this is Tata Motors electric car. This is designed to have a range of 300 kilometer under per single charge, and it can go 0 to 100 in just 7 seconds. So again, this is a very futuristic car. Again, this is a concept SUV. If you see, it looks so beautiful. It doesn't look like it is made by Tata Motors. The design language is completely changed here. If you see Tata Motors H5X, and again, this car looks like it is completely from a different planet itself. 45X, this car looks so beautiful. Now we are going to cover the balance sheet financials of this particular company. If you go to I've taken only the important figures in this particular presentation. If you take the equity of this particular company is quite fixed. The company has not raised equities, but if you see the reserve of the company is down from the current FY16 to FY17, these are down in the reserve for the capital. Around 20,000 crores is down, the reserve of the company is down by 20 crores, which is a very bad sign. If you go to the long-term borrowings, the company has gone up by 10,000 crores, again very bad sign. If you talk about total non-current liability, it is very high, around close to 1 lakh crores is the non-current liability. Overall non-current liability is very big. Current liability is around 1,15,629 crores in the FY17. Fixed asset is around 1,28,000 crore, nothing much to talk about. And if you talk about total current asset, it is around 1,16,000, and current liability is 1,15,000, which is in the 1:1 ratio, which is a bad ratio. It should be at least 2:1 ratio. Profit and loss statement, again, if you see, there is no major growth is happening in the past 3 years in the revenue segment. If you see from FY15 to 17, it is quite fixed, and in FY17 actually there is a fall in the revenue from if you compare it with FY16. And if you talk about financial cost of the company, it is gone up from 13 to 17 now. Although there is a little fall in the FY17, but the long term borrowings is very high and the finance cost is very high. And if you talk about profit of the company, if you see FY17 it was 14,000 crore, FY15 14,000 crore, FY16 11,000 crore, FY17 6,000 crore. There is a big fall happening in this particular area of profit and loss, in the profit and loss segment, which is a very very bad sign again. And the EPS of the company has fallen as the profit has fallen. So if you see, I'm not very satisfied with the financials of this particular company, although the company is taking very strong action plan, you know, to revive the business. But as of now, we have not seen that improvement happening in the financial statement. If you go to the quarter results, again, if you see the total revenue in Q4 FY17, it was 77,000 crore. Q1 FY18, 58,000 crore, big fall. But again, Q2 recovered 70,000 crore. And Q3 74,000 crore. So clear improvement can be seen in quarter results. In the quarter one, two, three, clear improvement can be seen. We have to wait and see what is going to happen in the Q4, which is going to result is going to come on 23rd of May. If you talk about profit, there is a continuous fall in the last four quarters in the profit. If you see Q4 FY17, 3,900 crores, then 2,500 crore, 1,991 crore, 9,061 crore. This continuous fall happening in the net profit of the company in the last four quarter, which is a very very bad sign. But I think this is a time where the bottom has already happened. The company is started to take strong action plan, and from here the company should all once again start to perform good. And I think in the Q4 we are going to see some sort of improvement happening. I'm quite optimistic about in this particular area right now, because the company has already started to take very strong action, and the company's improvement can be seen in the market. Like if you observe in the market, the number of Tata cars, like passenger vehicles, I'm not talking about IndyCar, in the other cars like Tigor, Tiago, Hexa, Nixon, the response is quite good in the consumer market. So because of that, I think the companies have started to revive right now. If you talk about JLR retail sales growth, if you see in UK, the sales growth is very good, from 86,000 units to 1,24,755 units, which is a very good sales in the UK market. North Korean market, very good sales, 24% jump. European market, 13% jump. Chinese market, very very good, got 32% jump in the Chinese market. And overall market, if you see, there's a 16% jump happening. And R&D expenditure, if you see, it has gone up in the FY17 to 1700 crores from 1400 crores in the FY14-15. If you talk about Tata Motors market share, if you see in the commercial vehicle segment, the market share of Tata Motors was 49%, but in FY16-17 it was 44%. There's a clear fall happened in the Tata Motors market share. That was the company's is suffering. And passenger vehicle, if you see, from 5.2% to 2%, but there's a jump from happening from the 2015-16 to 2016-17. There's a jump happened in the market share. That is a very good sign, and I'm expecting even more jump in the FY16-17-18, because the market company has started to recover now. And this is the latest news about the company which came in the recent past. Like Tata Motors, April domestic sales up by 86% to 5,351 units. The company sold 28,000 units during the same month previous year. The company sold around 28,000 units in the last month, April 2017. The company sold 28,000 units, but in April 2018, the company sold 53,000 units, which is 86% jump, which is a very good sign. It is clearly can be seen the company started to recover, what I feel. If you talk about like Tata Motor sales jumped 3% recently on April, when the Jaguar Land Rover gave like robust sales growth number. The retail sales of it was around 45,180 units, which is like 11.9%, almost 12% jump year on year. Retail sales up significantly on China, like China it went up by almost 29%, UK by 26%, overseas market 21%, and North America not much, 2.1%. In Europe market there was a fall happened. And JLR India post 83% rise in FY18 sales, line up with 10 new products for FY18-19. So JLR sales in India also is like, it is up by 83%, and the company is already ready with 10 new products for the current coming year. So now next step, Stockaholic report card. If you talk about the brand image of Tata Motors, it is not very, very good. I am quite neutral on that. Although the brand image of a JLR is very, very good, excellent, but Tata Motor itself, it is not very good as of now. It is improving year after year, but it is not very good now, because whenever people talk about Tata Motor, it is like Indica, Taxi, that type of image the company has got. Product quality is, it is of decent quality, it is not very high grade, high quality, it is not also very low quality. I've seen people complaining about few parts, or maybe here and there some sort of sound is coming, they complain also such things. But product quality is decent, it is not at this price level, it is good, but not a very excellent quality. New product development is very, very positive on that area. The company is developing new product very fast, and their future concepts are very good. So they are, I'm very, very positive in this particular area, but we need to consider other companies are also working equally hard. Future plans of the company is again very good. The company is already started to develop electric vehicle on hybrid segment, or for all commercial vehicle as well as passenger vehicle. Their future plans of action is very good, right? They are moving on the right direction. Finances of the company are not satisfied as of now, although I'm expecting some improvement happening from here after, from this quarter, but as of till now, whatever data we have, that is not satisfactory. Risk meter is high. If you are investing in this particular company, then risk is high, because this company can give you a very good return if the company revives, but risk is high because the thing is, the competition in the market, in this particular automobile industry, is very, very high. It is a very competitive market. Other players are also developing new product, although Tata is developing, so others are not going to sit quiet. Even they are developing, so they are developing new products, and they have a very good brand image as well. Tata is developing very good products, but as of now, the brand image is not that good as of other companies like Maruti Suzuki or Hyundai. So that is the reason I am considering risk investment in this particular company is going to be a little risky, but if the company revives, the return is going to be very, very good. So that is my personal opinion, and I think the company is trading at all time low of as of now. If you have not bought this share, you can take a chance, and it can be bought at this price level. I think it is all time low. So this is the time when the company is at bottom level, and because of the poor performance, the company is now at bottom level. But now the company has started to revive, and the company may revive in the coming few years, and because of that, the company should start to perform good in the coming future, and because of that, share prices once again, it will start to go up. That is my personal opinion, because if you see, lots of changes can be seen in this particular company. If you see in the commercial, like, people's point of view is also changing, and JLR is doing good. The only problem is Tata with Tata Motors, and Tata company is also trying to revive. They're coming with so many new brand, and people are quite positive about their new products. So that is my personal opinion. If you like my video, please subscribe to the channel, and please click on the like button, and please share it with your friends and family so that others can watch this video and take advantage of such videos. So I'll see you next week with a new company with a new video. Bye, take care.